Me, I'm a bit lazy, so while I arrive to the locker, I check my phone for 40 minutes.
Ah, that's also happened
to
me. No,
basically for me it's 1 minute, but on real life it's 40 minutes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then I go to take shower and it's already afternoon. Hey, Irina, what's up?
So, Andre, how is the ATP locker room looks like? Are you like having conversations, having fun, or? Because I'm the person who is like spending like maximum 15 minutes in the locker room just to try to get changed and just going to do my own things, like prepare the match or like eat or whatever. So, but usually I'm not really speaking with the opponent. What about you?
No, opponents for sure not, but sometimes if I see
the friend,
I can talk to him. Me, I'm a bit lazy, so while I arrive to the locker, I check my phone for 40 minutes.
Ah, that's also happened
no,
to me.
No, basically for me it's 1 minute, but on real life it's 40 minutes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then I go to take shower and it's already afternoon.
No, it's also happened to me sometimes. You just, I feel like it's few minutes and you already check the time and it's like...
You're late for match already.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so Irina, before the match, is when, I don't know, half an hour left, you have any routines that you like to follow?
Just my regular warm-up, actually, like maybe drink some coffee or whatever, make sure I'm ready for the match, and then just warm-up and maybe some fun with the team to get relaxed a little bit and go for the match.
And every time it's the same warm-up? Or
actually, yeah, overall it's the same extent.
In the same shower, in the same spot?
Well, I'm trying to stay away from these things, but sometimes...
It's killing you, right?
Yeah, you're like, it's in my head, like, okay, I better go there. I can control it. Then I change it. What about you, actually? Yeah.
Of course, the same. If I start to win, especially good matches, I go the same
what
shower for sure.
What if someone in the same spot, in your spot?
I mean, normally...
You'll wait, you'll get away?
No, I mean, me, I'm a bit different. I go always the... far as shower as possible. So most of the players, they are so lazy to arrive that far. So most of the time it's almost free always.
So you, from the beginning of the tournament, you're already thinking like to make sure that nobody will take your shower till the end.
Yeah.
Okay, this is smart. I have to follow your routine.
And you wait?
Not really. I'm like, okay, it's not about this. It's about my tennis and what I'm doing on the court.
And then the forehand mistake, why I don't go to the same shower?
It's all about this, yeah. So, you get nervous before the match?
Of course.
I think everyone does, yeah?
I mean, all of us humans, so of course we're nervous, we're tight, the hands are shaking. This is
normal. That's kind of normal, yeah, I agree.
This is part of the sport, and in the end I think we get addicted to it.
How to deal with this,
No, not even deal. In the beginning, looks like while we're playing, I think we hate this feeling, like, again, I'm super nervous. But as soon as, if you take out this feeling from us, we are addicted. Like, we want to feel these emotions.
Yeah, that's true. That's actually about these emotions. And
then we try to find it somewhere else, doing, I don't know, some adrenaline stuff to find this again, I think.
Yeah, that's true.
When happens that you're losing the matches, what you're doing? You want to destroy all the club?
Yeah, sometimes I can... I throw my bags, I can like broke my racket.
You destroy the room in the hotels sometimes or no?
Actually, by the time when I get back to the room, I'm getting a little bit like cooler, so I'm already like forget the shit, but I can cry in the locker room a little bit, like when I like be so disappointed and like sad and all these emotions. I think you know what I'm talking about. For sure you're not crying, you're just destroying everything.
No, I'm crying and destroying the same time.
Really?
Yes.
I want to see you crying. Because I can imagine like you crying, you're like, seems like really a funny guy.
So Irina, it was nice to talk to you. Wish you all the best and good luck here in Roma.
Thank you too. It was a nice conversation. Ha ha ha.